How could you secure him? How would you secure him getting that title belt?
You mean Joe Joyce?
Yeah, Joe Joyce.
Yeah, looked spectacular. He broke one of the longest-standing records in any sport, a 104-year-old record, to become in only his fourth fight the British heavyweight champion, Commonwealth champion, British Commonwealth champion. And so he looks spectacular. I mean, in every fight he does, he looks spectacular. He wanted to fight Derek Chisora, offered Chisora a lot of money, like over $200,000. He turned it down. Now he told me, Joe, he would like to fight Baby Miller. So I've been talking to Baby Miller's promoter, Dimitri Salida and Greg Bowen, to see if that fight can be made. He's ready, you know, he's ready to take on anyone. And it seems like, I never really like to use that, but he's truly one of the most avoided fighters right now in the sport. And so we're going to have to start moving him up in the rankings so that hopefully within a 12-month period, he can start moving into somewhere in one of the mandatory positions and participate in a final eliminator to challenge for one of the heavyweight titles. And that's what we're going to do, because my goal is to have Joe Joyce fight and win a heavyweight title next year.
All right, thank you so much, Richard.
And really elevate the sport. And I think here in the U.S., we have a handful of fighters which are right on the cusp of really igniting boxing to make it a mass sport. And these are, two of them are the Charlos. I think Deontay Wilder would beat Anthony Joshua if that fight happened. Somebody like Deontay Wilder can be that spark as well. And then, of course, Mikey Garcia, bilingual. We haven't had a bilingual star like that since Oscar, really. And so, so there's a handful of fighters. You have the very charismatic and colorful Adrian Broner. Then, of course, you have in the with Leo and with Abner, you have